Good afternoon. Four-year-old girl presented with recurrent attacks of bilateral upper and lower inner eyelid lesion associated with discomfort, discharge, and photophobia since first week of life. Visual acuity, right 6/9 partial, left 6/12 6/12. Refraction with right plus 1.5 diopter sphere and left plus 1.5 diopter sphere. History. The lesions are bilateral, chronic, recurrent, associated with photophobia, discomfort, serous discharge, aggravated by upper respiratory tract infections. Medical history and surgical history negative. Surgical history, many attempts of removal were done with recurrence of the same lesion after each attempt. Family history negative, drug history. The patient was on Isomogyl lubricant eye ointment and unidose preservative-free cyclosporine A eye drops, which significantly reduced the recurrence of the lesion. By examination, the eyelid and the conjoint swelling, edema, upper and lower tarsal conjunctival multiple red yellow mass of hard woody consistency that bleed on removal. Fornix and bulbar conge were mildly injected with serous discharge. Cornea, mild superficial corneal opacity, right eye. Anterior segment and posterior segment, normal. Differential diagnosis of chronic conjunctivitis may be giant papillary, papillary, granulomatous, follicular, membranous, and cicatrizing. Giant papillary may be vernal keratoconjunctivitis, palpebral and limbal, atopic, and secondary giant papillary due to contact lens, prosthesis, loose suture. Maybe papillary, just papillary, unilateral and bilateral, unilateral chronic dacryocystitis and bilateral blepharoconjunctivitis and keratoconjunctivitis seca. Follicular chronic conjunctivitis is membranous, chlamydia, toxic, Lyme disease, cicatrizing, pemphigoid and Stevens-Johnson syndrome, trachoma, tumor, trachoma, trauma, and burn. Granulomatous, paranoid oculoglandular syndrome, and sarcoidosis, membranous, lesionous conjunctivitis. Lesionous conjunctivitis is the only chronic membranous conjunctivitis. Our picture for case, this picture, photograph showing upper and lower tarsal conjunctival pseudomembranes, mild lid swelling, erythema, photophobia, tarsal conjunctival mass, red to yellow in color with firm consistency, with corneal complications, superficial epithelial opacities. So it is a case of lesionous conjunctivitis. Lesionous conjunctivitis is a rare form of chronic recurrent conjunctivitis characterized by fibrinous pseudomembrane on palpebral conjunctiva. It may be associated with systemic pseudomembranes, lesion of gingiva, air, tracheobronchial, bronchial tract, female genital tract, and kidneys. Lesionous conjunctivitis may be inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern due to mutation in the plasminogen gene and a variety of other genes associated with type 1 plasminogen deficiency, leading to the impaired wound healing. The episode may be triggered by minor trauma, fever, and antifibrinolytic therapy. Diagnosis depends on clinical history and examination, also by the laboratory data that show decrease in plasminogen activity, and the pathology show pseudomembrane with fibrin-rich component. This is another picture for our case. The management, treatment tend to be unsatisfactory and spontaneous resolution is rare. There is medical therapy and surgical therapy. Medical therapy, topical plasminogen, topical fresh frozen plasma and systemic fresh frozen plasma, topical heparin plus topical corticosteroid or alpha chymotrypsin, topical cyclosporine A with amniotic membrane, systemic low dose plasminogen. Medical follow-up. This patient needs to be evaluated frequently to monitor for recurrence of pseudomembrane while the initial follow-up will be more frequent once the treatment is tapered off. These patients are still at risk of recurrence soon after treatment or even many years later. Polycarbonate glasses may be helpful in protecting the eye from environmental trauma and initiating the cascade of lesional conjunctivitis. Surgery. Surgical excision alone has a tendency to lead to rapid recurrence of pseudomembranous due to trauma induced in these patients who have deficient wound healing. So, surgery should be associated with pre and post treatment with topical plasminogen if available, steroid, topical fresh frozen plasma, topical and systemic, topical cyclosporin or topical heparin to maximize the chance of recovery without recurrence. Surgical follow-up, this patient should be seen within days following excision of pseudomembrane to evaluate for reformation, which can occur as early as 48 hours. Lifestyle approach, lifestyle modification involve avoidance of source of trauma and infection and the restrainment of daily activities in children during the early post-operative period. Parents are educated to detect new lesion and may be taught to remove the new small lesion with cotton-tipped applicator while they are applying the eye drops. Thank you.